Thank you. Thank you. Put up a few of my pieces.
Thank you.
And some whack psychology began to destroy the historical record of slavery in Brazil. psychological racism in Brazil. And Capoeira continued to emerge under that sort of system. And in 1935 or so, Master Gumba, 1930, Master Gumba began to Manuel de Reis de Chávez, began to create another system for Capoeira called Capoeira Regional, and began to repopularize, if you will. After Master Castinha and others, Caramon and Angola, he began to create a capoeira that was more of a fighting style of capoeira. And so from 1930s to the present, until his death, Master Gumba brought capoeira, along with other masters and capoeiristas, to a national art form where it's today's practice as a national art in Brazil. And of course, looking at these faces here from Italy, from all over the place, capoeira is practiced all over the world today. So in the capsule, that's essentially where capoeira came from. And you, what you represent, is the next generation of capoeira. Taking that legacy on, be it Castinha, be it Bimba, be it John Ranzi, whoever, taking that capoeira legacy forward. So we encourage you to continue to practice, continue to take it serious, continue to train, and let's build a clear, undisputable legacy of what capoeira was, what capoeira is, and what capoeira will become. Okay? All right. Any questions?
Wow. Yeah, you talked about what it was and kind of what it is. You have an idea of what you see it becoming and what you'd like to see.
I wish I had that. I wish I was God. So it's impossible to say. What is it going to become? As capoeira, I hope capoeira remain rooted in its traditions, in the essence of capoeira, what I call the essence of capoeira. That is the true art form of capoeira. And that's what we're trying to teach here. What we call, and that's not a sort of vanity or sort of an arrogance, if you will, but we want to maintain the essence of capoeira. As capoeira get exported, and as you know, it can become faddish, particularly when it comes to America, everything becomes faddish, right? But we want to maintain the true essence of capoeira, the way the original teachers had thought capoeira should be taught and cared for. And that knowledge, believe me, I know, that knowledge is embedded in this man right here, who has a third generation of mastery from, a second generation of mastery from Master Gumba. And so it's incumbent upon us, as we have fun in capoeira, create all the joy and happiness around capoeira, that we really understand what the essence of capoeira is all about. And I'm not going to stand here and tell you what the essence of capoeira is all about. You're going to have to train hard to learn that. But where I would like to see it, I guess from my perspective, where I would like to see capoeira, I would like to see capoeira, yeah, practice all over the world. I would like to someday sail down the Niger River and stop off in the many Niger, sing from a capoeira along the banks of the Niger River. I would like to go up in the Amazon jungle and see, you know, see the native Brazilians doing capoeira there. You know, I would like to go down in Florida Keys and capoeira there. I would go up in Canada and see the tour doing capoeira. But that's just my take. But realistically, it's upon us to carry forward the definition of what our future is. And as we give definition to that future, again, I hope we may stay true. Stay true to what that capoeira, the essence of capoeira, is all about. Okay. Yes, ma'am.
We seem to make a lot of sounds in capoeira, and it's in one of the more like oral traditions. I'm just wondering, like, are there any sounds that jump out at you as like reflections of the past, like telling stories of where it actually has happened or resembles something that happened in the past, and where those stories came from, who the sounds came from, and what are the stories behind them?
I believe that most of the songs, especially the ones that talk about the history of capoeira and the culture of Brazil, especially Bahia, out of Brazil, many things have to be changed to fit in the new country. Or the songs can be problems because, you know, for make sense, the song, the words, and the meaning, everything, it's extremely difficult for people from different cultures to understand. Sometimes they have that wrong idea. For example, in Canada, the guy that we call Padre, small guy, he's from Brazil, was teaching the University of somewhere in Canada, I can't remember the city, but anyway, he almost is out of the university. because the song says, I can't remember the name of the song, but anyway, somebody in the group translates the song and then turned, she believed that the song was discriminated against Afro people. So that became a big problem then on the vest, and then she had to stop teaching us again, because it was a song that came from Brazil and she was taught then on the vest, because people didn't understand me and all that. So it turned to be a problem. That's what, like I said, you know, many songs in Capoeira, I believe, does not work in other countries. Many different things in the Capoeira itself have to be changed. Make sense what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. But, very
interested in the culture of Brazil. And that's what I want to do in this city. Always have been my goal. And I really appreciate the support that I, you know, had. That's why I'm here. We are very close, we work very hard to get our space. But for me, you know, I have not 100%. The reason for that is I never taught capoeira outside of academia. For example, here here a long time ago was a church, and it's a basketball scene, it's the basketball. I haven't taught capoeira all over the place, but I never taught capoeira in the United States in academia. It's completely different, the atmosphere, the energy, and everything, because, you know, it's a kind of a, for example, myself, I was training in the academy, you know, and I came from the academy of Bimba, was the power of the capoeira regional, all. And then, if you're talking on the stage, I'm still teaching, you know, but never in the academy, but I'm very close to have my own academy. I guarantee the others is completely better in all aspects. So.
Any other questions? What about the training? Any questions about the training? You don't want to do any demonstrations on it. Are there any questions related to your training? Do you understand what's going on? This is the new training.
I would like to do some comments in terms of training. I have been here for all these years. What I have been teaching the capoeira art, no contact, but I just have to remind you, inside this system have many different things involved in art. Okay, it's a capoeira, capoeira art, like the way we do. Just the movement, the music, no contact. Also, we have the same thing, it's a full contact. Plus, we have the combat system, is how to use the capoeira as a fight. It's completely different the way you train with the movement, because in the street is a different deal. So we have that too. We have competition, demonstration, things that are many different ways. So we are very close to continue to add more and more new steps to the art. And the reason that I never thought full contact in the capoeira or a combat the capoeira, because the law in the United States is completely different from Brazil. In Brazil, I mean, if you want to learn, it's fine. Whatever happened to you is your problem. You go home, you take care of hospital, whatever, and then you come back again. No, but here is different to you. You have to, you know, things is, you know, you want to be happy, saving, you know. Then, like I said, things when you go to a point for another, things have to be changed. Even in part of the art, like that, many people ask me all the time, hey, Ellen, why you insist not to use nickname your students? I don't believe it. That in the United States work well. I just don't believe it. And some masters I realize that they are stopping to do that too because they want to follow us. But I knew that a long time ago. Well, in Brazil, in the academy in Brazil, we don't care how you feel. That's the way it is. It's how you think, hey, that's it. Everybody have nickname, you have nickname to whatever. They figure out the nickname, that's the way they're gonna call you there if you like or not. Here, it can be offense and only, you know what I mean? But the idea, the nickname is not to offend anybody. You know, it's just to somebody have a nickname. It can be, you have a couple of instances, all kind of, like animals, name, for example. You know, but also the second reason that I don't believe anymore in that because capoeira is so big today and what happened, so many people say the same nickname. So there are no reason anymore. That's why I don't use nickname. So sometimes it works, sometimes it don't.
But you know, there's no problem. We still got a few nicknames sprinkled around here, right?
Right.
That's
the problem.
That's not my
here in the United States in different countries. Have people that have names that have nothing to do with anything. That's not fair in the capoeira. So the piece that people are missing the point, you know, but people have to understand how to make that work. That's why it's very difficult today. Like for example, now can you imagine every week try to find a nickname for somebody with our work? It's too many people doing capoeira today. One day the capoeira was just in Bahia. That's why hundreds of people doing capoeira. It was not a problem. Then it started growing all over Brazil. You know, people are, who is Mestre Gato? Was Tem Gato.
Gato Bom, Gato Doce,
Gato Doce. That's a problem. But again, the nickname is just one day. One.
So, what's next? There's another question about training. Anybody clear on where you're heading? There's going to be certain cases given out later on. And I'll let you go and everybody successfully complete the evaluation. So,
is he your main
Say again?
Is he your main
We won't talk about that one.
training in Academia Japan, but in Academia Domestic Chino and a few other places. We're going to get taken to the inside by this right here and to many places that we probably will never find. Going to participate and see some street artists. We'll see, just like the minister was talking about, the different aspects of capoeira, and the aspect of capoeira, the dance, the combat, and all of the different aspects. I think we're going to get a really good taste of what that's all about going into Brazil. And Master is most graciously offering us a place to stay on his property, and so we're going to have accommodations taken care of. It's going to be very reasonable. The whole cost of the trip is $1,650 for plane fare and everything, aside from just miscellaneous costs if you want to bring back souvenirs and stuff. So it's going to be a great trip, and I hope to see as many people there.
Yeah, I really recommend everybody to consider going, because the experience in Brazil is once in a lifetime, and things you see there are things that you won't be able to capture here in the U.S. To step it up to another level of capoeira, you definitely need to go to Brazil to see where capoeira is and where capoeira is going, and the energy that you get in Bahia, where capoeira has not come from, is unique to anywhere else in the world. So I really recommend everybody consider going to the trip, because it's priceless what you'll see and what you'll gain from Brazil. I recommend everybody to go.
After we got back about a month ago and stayed at in your master's place, was it comfortable?
Yeah, it's wonderful.
Everybody sign up. You can't beat the price, certainly, folks. But to get an experience at the different price is definitely once in a lifetime.
Well, the idea was to make it as cheap as possible so as many people could go in and just want to take a big group and have a strong chain down there. And bring all that energy back.
Next up, folks, this is our Batizado. I'm just certificated for the accomplishment of last year. Pick it up to the next level for the summer year. Alright? Everybody ready?
Ben Mashuk.
Thank you.
Thank you. Carolyn Moore. Moore. Carolyn Moore.
She's up here.
John Rochefort. Not here. Nicole Coletto. Nicole Coletto. Brianna Pedersen. Brian Benson.
Yeah, I think we have one Justin.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. And Susan.
Yes.
Where do you have any certificates?
Well, yeah, what I'll do is come up and take a break.
Thank you.
stuck the same the whole time.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.